I've made a copy of ODB 37, and I'm calling this one ODB 38 Normalizing Part 2. In the last video, we created a group table using SQL and populating it with group information on our employee table. We're going to do the same thing for our department information in this video, but this time we're going to add a constraint to a field in our department table. Our department table will hold only information about the departments. It will have a field for department ID, a field for department name, but on this table, we also want to add a field for the department contact person. The requirements for our department contact person are: there can only be one person assigned to each department. There does not need to be a department contact person assigned, but if there is one, they will have to be on our employee table. I have a query here that we're going to run to create the department table, and I will put this out on the website in case any of you want to download it. The first thing we notice is the table name is TBL_department. On our first line, we delete it if it exists. If it's not there, there's no problem. It just continues on. Then we create the table, and inside the parentheses, we have the fields that we're going to create. We've got our department ID, which will be auto-valued starting with 0. It is not null, and it is our primary key. The next field is the department name, varchar 100, not null, so it must be there. And our third field is a department contact person with an integer value. This one will allow nulls or no values. This last value here is our constraint. We start off with the word constraint. This second part, this is a variable that I made up. The FKC is for foreign key constraint, and then the DCP is for department contact person. I believe any valid variable name should work. This is what I'm choosing for mine. Then we've got foreign key, because this is a foreign key constraint. Department contact person, that is the value on this table. Then we say references, the table employees, so this is the employee table. And this last one is the field on the employees table that our value must be in. I mentioned before, when we have foreign keys, that I like to keep the names the same when possible. In this case, it doesn't make sense because it wouldn't be clear to us what this field is for. Perhaps I should have called this Department Contact Employee ID. That might be a little clearer, but these are the kinds of decisions that you, as a DBA, will need to make. It seems like such a small thing, but this could be a very big thing to other people, as well as yourself, when making updates to your database in a few weeks or years from now. Try and set up some standards and try and stick to them as best you can. Let's run this query. I'm going to select it. And paste using Control V. Execute. And we've created our table. We don't see it yet. I need to go into View, Refresh Tables. And the first table I'm going to assign is going to be unassigned. And here we've got the SQL to fill the rest of the table. We're going to insert into the department table, department name, selecting distinct department from our employees table. Copying that and pasting with using Control V. Looks like everything went okay. Let's open up our department table. Now we want to assign a department contact person. So I'm going to open up our employees table and select one person from each department and put them as the department contact person. So for the accounting, I'm going to assign number 5. From the IT department, I'm going to assign 13. From the management department, we're going to assign number 19. From the manufacturing, we're going to place in number 24. From marketing, number 26. And from security, number 29. Now, if we put in someone that's not in there, let's say instead of 13, we placed in number 0. We don't have a 0. We get an error. So let's change that back to 13 and close that table. We're also going to close our employees table. The last thing I want to do is check the relationships for my table. And it looks like the department table is got a relationship with the employee phone table. That doesn't seem right. I'm going to move the group table to the side there. Move over our phone. And when I move over the department table, we see that we have it was just over the employees table. So that was misleading. Employee phone is going to our employee table, and our department table has got a relationship with our table employees. I'm going to click on the line here, right click and edit to see what kind of relationship we have. What we're saying here is on the employee table, if we delete off an employee ID, there'll be no action on the update or the delete. Well, if we update the employee ID, we want that to cascade down. But if we delete an employee, we don't want to delete the record off of our department table. We're going to set this to null because we already said a department does not have to have a department contact person. And right here, it would probably be clearer if I would have said department contact employee ID instead of person. So I may change that, but for now, we're going to leave it. I'm going to click OK. I want to save this relationship. Closing our relationship window and saving our database.